taking over me. LACM Vocal Department Showcase. At the end of the quarter, we always do this, and I don't think it's ever going to be any more fun than it is tonight. So just had a wonderful sound check. You guys were on it. You're together having fun. And thank you so much for our tech folks. We never give a hand to them. Let's just do that now because I'm going to forget later. Thank you, everybody. All right. We have a special guest tonight. We don't usually do this. This is just usually for us. But we have a special guest, a friend for many years, and a wonderful singer, producer, a wonderful musician. He's also an educator. He's also the vice dean at the Commercial School of Music at USC, where I got my master's in jazz. But he's the man. He's really a one-stop shop for whatever you want. And hopefully you get a chance to work with him at some point. But for tonight, he's going to give you some feedback. I want to introduce, if you would, please give a warm welcome to Sean Holt. We're not on yet. It's that mute button. No, not on you, not for you. It was there just a minute ago. I'll bring you a microphone if we need it. Did somebody step on it? Uh-huh, sounds right. Sean Holt.
Hello, everybody, how are you? It's okay. We're not going to let that mic check set us off in the wrong direction. I'm really happy to be here tonight. It's a pleasure to join the esteemed Mr. David Joyce, and I know you've got to be serious if this guy's in charge. So I'm excited to hear you. I'm going to try and do my best to give you some meaningful feedback. I know that we've got a lot of music to hear, so I'll keep my comments brief and hope that they can hold some valuable insight for you. It's a pleasure. I look forward to hearing you. Let's get started. If I could ask that our lead vocalist get up and maybe just let me know your name, tell me just a couple of things about you and what you're going to sing, and just a very brief introduction, that would help me a lot.
Hello, one, two. You got it. Okay, my name is Barbara. I'm from Mexico. You can call me Barbie. I like that better. I'm 19 years old. I'm about to sing Valerie by Amy Winehouse. I like chocolate, and yeah, I just moved in recently here to LA.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I like chocolate too, so you can swing by my desk on the way out if you have some.
Nice, thank you. You ready to go?
I'm ready when you are.
Perfect. Okay. So I wanted to start saying, how are you, LACM? Wow, that's actually really great. I thought I would have to say again, like, how are you? But great. Okay. Some of you already heard me sing this song. So if you know this, sing along, come on. But first, before we start, I want to introduce this amazing band. We have here on the drums, Benton. We have on the bass, Lucas. On the keyboards, we got Maddie. And of course, Ethan on the guitar.
Across
Barbara, that was a great way to start the night. My goodness. Can you hear me in your monitor?
You.
Can you hear me in your wedge?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I loved your pre-song energy. I love the way you owned the stage from the moment you walked up there.
Thank you so much.
You made me smile. You made me have a good time. You required me to have a good time. And right off the bat, I forgot where I was. You changed my state. That's what I'm looking for singers. I want you to own the stage before you ever sing a note, right?
Yeah, thank you so much.
Your voice sounds great. That was a good key for you. It was a really good casting. A lot of singers choose songs that we like, but not necessarily songs that we should be singing, right? Yeah. So it's very important for us to always make sure that we're paying close attention to the casting and whether or not the voice that we have, that we bring to something, is really right for the vehicle, that the songs that we choose. Be sure and take advantage of and work with your band to deliver me between these sections. What I felt in the arrangement here was that the energy pretty much was, once we started, it kind of stayed here. Yeah. I would love for you guys, including the band and the vocals, to take advantage of those pre-choruses and let things come down just a little bit. Because remember, you know, in Nashville, they call pre-choruses ramps, right? You know why they call them a ramp?
No, I don't.
Because verses are surface streets. Ramps are the on-ramp to the freeway, and the chorus is the freeway, okay? So the ramp is headed somewhere, and I'd love for the ramps in your song to take breathe a little bit, let them come down a little bit in volume. Gives you a chance to elongate the phrase. And why would we want to do that? Because your verses are very fragmented in the way that the melodies are very rhythmic, right? They're frenetic.
Yeah.
The choruses are very choppy. Valerie, 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 right? Use that chorus as a way to, I mean that pre-chorus as a way to elongate your phrases. You'll keep me more interested. I won't feel like I'm in the same story all the way through the song. Deal?
Deal.
Excellent job, band and vocal. Great way to get started. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, band. You're amazing. Okay, now before I get off the stage, I'm about to introduce the second performer of the night. She's a great singer and a great friend. Come on, everybody, give it up for Sophia! Check. Okay, hello. Hi, everyone. How's everyone doing tonight? Good? Okay. My name is Sophia, and I'm from India. I will be accompanied with Pascal. Give a big round of applause for Pascal. Fun fact about me, I can do this. Yeah, go ahead, try it out, don't break your thumbs. Just yeah. Okay. Okay. We can start. Yeah.
That Arizona sky burning in your eyes. Catch on fire, it's buried in my soul, like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up, we go how to rhyme the day.
Hard to balance in these heels.
Sophia, is that how you say it?
Yeah.
Beautiful job. Really wonderful. You too had a wonderful stage presence as you walked to the microphone. And
thank
you for inviting me into this moment. You did that rather well. I also like the way you shifted in your energy to prepare for the song. So once you committed to that moment, you let your body and everything about you shift to prepare for the a more intimate moment, and that required me to come along for the ride, which I really appreciate.
Thank you.
Suggestion, take advantage of the proximity effect of these microphones, okay? When you sing a ballad, that's your mic, right? You're not sharing?
Yeah, this is my mic.
When you sing a mic, I want that windscreen touching your lips on a ballad in a really intimate moment. Sure. You want to take advantage of proximity. Every half inch you move away from that microphone, you lose the potential for you lose the potential for the dynamic floor that you have available to you in this ballad.
Right.
You can certainly work it when you get ready to go up higher, but I'd love for it to be touching your lips when you're in the verse. It's much more emotional. Okay, so you were losing a lot because you were back from it. A 2-octave-plus song is a big ask, right?
Mm-hmm.
Something that I try and get my students to do and something that I was encouraged to do. Moving forward, I would love for you to take in a lot less air. You'd be surprised how little air it takes
right.
to sing big sounds. And I think that might, if you take in less air, use the least dispensable amount of air that you can do to create those long phrases. What that'll require you to do is use more compression vocally.
Mm-hmm.
And that compression is going to let you create something that sounds more like a whine. And that whine is going to make your phrases longer. It's also going to help your pitch, which in certain places was climbing up a little bit for you. So I want you to consider all those things as you move back into your lessons. Talk about things about compression and some of the things that you can do to kind of get that thing to whine a little more. Because great singing really, it comes from those places. It comes from small, small amounts of air that we squeeze and create. And in a ballad, it really is, it's even more necessary. Beautiful emotion. Really, really, I felt very connected to you and bravo.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Before I leave the stage, I would like to introduce you to my very talented friend, Yellow. Please give it up for Yellow, everyone.
Hello everyone, my name is Yellow, and today I would like to perform All of Me, which is really romantic song. Hope you guys enjoy it.
Showing me and you kicking.
Thank you so much.
Wow, Yellow, that's a big, beautiful, beautiful alto tone. So great. Just you sound wonderful. There's a pulse in these ballads that sometimes we don't pay enough attention to or place enough importance on. And in this song, which is going by right here, that might be the tempo, but that's not what's pushing this song forward. What's pushing the song forward is "You Give Me Y'all." So if you go find the most, the busiest part of your melody, you'll usually find the subdivision that's propelling the song along. And so even though some of you are down, 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 do, dee, da, da, do, do, down, 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 it's a lot slower, I want you to be feeling the subdivision of the song even when you're not singing notes that singing those eighth notes, okay? Why does that matter? Why do you think that matters? Because the first thing listeners will check out, like leave the moment on, is when rhythms don't land in their stomach. Did you know that? We don't ever hear lyrics, we never hear melody until rhythm is completely settled in our body. So what I want you to do, if you listen to John Legend sing this, it sounds like he's singing like a drummer, right? And some of my favorite singers are drummers, because they've always got propulsion and pulse at the forefront of how they're delivering, even on their longest lines. And that doesn't mean you're going to sing everything syncopated and very rhythmic, but you certainly need to internalize the rhythm of those moments. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
So
yes.
Think about that as you go forward. Another thing, you sound so great up there on the top of those notes. Do me a favor, drop that jaw even more to where it feels like it's about to fall off your face, because the larynx follows the jaw, and the moment that larynx drops and that jaw comes down, those notes that seem a little pinched at the top are going to open up and they're going to mix with something that's a little lower. They're going to mix with that lower rich part of our sound, and you're going to end up with something that even is more impactful than you've already got going, which is working well. And then lastly, when you get ready to kind of move into those belty kind of tones at the end of the song, when you get up into the chorus, work with your vocal teacher to modify those vowels. You were really wide, which makes the sound get a little bit, potentially a little bit slightly out of control. If you'll modify those vowels at the end of that song, you can stay big, you can stay in that part of your chest, but it won't feel like such a departure from the intimacy of the song, which you created so well in the beginning. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Beyond that, it was a lovely performance. Thank you so much. I really appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you so much.
Hi guys, so my name is Veljko Radenković, I'm from Serbia, and today I'm gonna perform the song, the one on Eurovision in 2006, it's gonna be in Serbian, and I hope you're gonna enjoy. Kada sklopim postelja prazna terasan život se topi i nestaje brzo ko dlanom od lan ko razum da gubim jer stvarnosti ne primećujem još uvek te ljubim Još uvek ti slepo verujem, ko luda ne znam kuda, ljubavi se nove bojim, a dane žive rane više ne brojim. Molitva kao žar na mojim usnama je molitva. Mesto reči samo ime tvoje nebo zna kao ja koliko puta sam ponovila to nebo zna baš kao ja da je ime tvoje moja jedina molitva Lagati sve dok se molim, a lažem ako kažem da te ne volim. Molitva, kao žar na mojim usnama je molitva, mesto reči samo.
Emotion in verse one. I love how intimate. I love how you invited me into that space. There's this imagery that I like to think about. You know, if you've been in the pool before and you've moved your arm against the water in your pool or their legs, there's this kind of pulling, right? This pulling through the water, And I think if you can keep that imagery alive in a song like this, you can pull those tones through this song so that they're really, really, there's a beautiful continuity. And in the phrasing, I think that's a metaphor that might even let you lean more into what you're already doing very successfully. Like I mentioned earlier, I really want you to use mic proximity on these ballads. Get right up on that thing, just like I'm talking to you right now. My lips are touching this microphone, and I want it'll further it will make your small sounds even more impactful if you get right up there on that microphone. My only comment for this is I would love for the key of this song to cost you more. As you started getting ready to open up and really lean into this, I felt you were limited by some of the lower range of this song. I think there's probably at least another whole step in this tune for you where it would cost you more in the best way possible. It would allow you to really open up into the emotion that I think you're trying to realize. And right now the song feels like it might have more potential there. Your rhythmic pulse was really great in this. I absolutely felt the groove, even though we didn't have a drummer. And believe it or not, I put all of the responsibility on my singers to make me feel the beat. I do not want the drums to have to deal with it. They come along for the ride, but if I can't hear the drums in your mouth, then we're nowhere, right? The singers have always got to deliver pulse and groove. You did that very effectively. And the dynamic range in this song was gorgeous. Your smallest smalls, your biggest bigs, very effective. Bravo, great job.
Thank you so much. Thank you. 1, 2, 3.
Check, check. Cool.
Hello, my name is Sam Gurule. I am from Santa Fe, New Mexico. And tonight I will be performing It's Been a Long, Long Time. Hope you enjoy. To me, there's so much I feel that I should say, but words can wait until some other day. Kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time. This, my dear, since can't remember when. It's been a long, long time. You'll never know how many dreams I dream about you, or just how empty they all seem without you. So kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long time.
Right on. Samantha, right?
Yeah.
Just beautiful.
Thank you. Really beautiful.
I'd like to ask the room to maybe hold back on the talking during the performances. If we could show a little respect to the audience, to the artists while they're up there, I'd appreciate it. The mic angle is very directional. These mics are very directional, dynamic mics. The minute you take that thing off axis and hold it up like it's aimed at your nose as opposed to aimed at your lips, you change the quality of the EQ of that thing, and you take about 30% of the volume away. So listen to how it changed. Did that change? Can you hear the difference? So that's the angle you were singing at. Now listen to that.
Okay.
Hear the difference?
Yeah.
So the EQ changes. It gets thinner because I'm talking basically in a part of the mic that's not responsive at all. Mm-hmm. So if you're singing on like a 58 or a 57 or anything like that, a dynamic mic, just make sure that you're right on it, okay?
Yeah.
Good job of the chromaticism in the song. That's very challenging, especially those first parts of the verses. Really chromatic. Bravo, you're well on your way with that thing, and that's a tough song for anybody. I can tell that you love this music. Are you a fan of jazz and crooner songs?
Yeah, I really 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 love jazz.
Yeah, I can hear I can hear that you do. Who are some of your favorite artists?
Vocal.
Yeah.
I really take a lot of inspiration from like Billie Holiday, Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald, all of the greats. So
great.
Chet Baker too.
I hear that in your sound. So continue to study those masters. Everything you need to know is right there in the listening. Okay. I would love to hear you come back after the saxophone solo to that key change with even more power. Oh. It seemed like you were a little hesitant to bring me back into that new key. I know how hard it is to stick a key like that when there's really nothing to help you land it. So you've got to hear those pitches. You'll want to find something to anchor on, whatever it is. It may be a note that you know the piano player is going to play right before you get back. Find your place to anchor and come back in with real conviction there and maybe another dynamic level up. Why am I saying that? Because right after you sing that little reentry, you get into something that's very small. And I think your smalls are smaller when your bigs are bigger. So but don't be scared to create a little bit more dynamic range, okay?
Okay.
And look ahead for those giant leaps at the end of the song.
Yeah.
You need more air to sing these longer phrases. And ironically, you need more air to sing softer passages, right? That doesn't mean subglottal pressure. It doesn't mean taking in big gulps of air. But it does mean that you're going to have enough to sustain you through those last few lines. So look ahead, read ahead. For what's coming, make sure that you've got enough there to lean into, and it'll give you the breath support that you need to negotiate those final, very intimate passages. But overall, I so commend you on choosing a song from this era and the genre, and you're well on your way to being an amazing song stylist in this genre. Great job.
Thank you. Before I get off the stage, I just wanted to introduce the next person coming up. Probably one of the most talented people, I personally think. Jelani!
Thank you so much. That was really sweet, honestly. And once again, give a round of applause for Samantha. She's amazing. I think you're the most talented. It's all the way around, honestly. Thank you so much. So this song that I'm going to be singing is an original song that I made. It's a pop song that I made, a very catchy, fun song that, you know, the vibe is just like you play it in a party, everyone's dancing, very, very catchy. Quick little run story. This song is just basically just about like how when I had first graduated from high school a few years ago, and I attended a college party, and it was my first type of experience in a party like that. And this is basically just about how I was feeling in the moment, what was going on in my head, the things that was happening. And just a really fun song. Hope you guys could clap along to it, dance along to it, whatever, sing along to it, and just catch a vibe. Thank you so much. Let's get it. Faded, 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 all so faded, 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 faded. She said, do you want a drink? Then said, I can make you one. I said, oh yes, please. I said, can you make it three? Next thing yo, high drunk another. And next thing yo, high smoke some other thing. Wanna ding. This is my type of thing. One thing led to another. I'm sipping outfit that I was rocking. Was dripping soon as I took the pop. I'm tripping. One thing led to another. I'm sipping faded.
My type of thing.
One thing led to another.
I'm sipping
that outfit, and I was rocking, and I was tripping that puff that I took.
I'm tripping.
Thank you.
Jelani, is that right?
Yes, that's correct.
That was a lot of fun, man.
Thank you so much.
That was a lot of fun. Thanks for sharing the story about that song before you started, too.
Thank you.
I'm really, really, so far, very pleased with the way you guys are owning your space on stage. Everybody so far has done a great job walking up to the mic, owning their space and taking over. And you did a great job as well.
Thank you.
Be sure and find your light.
Okay.
If you can see me, that probably means there's not enough light blaring in your eyes, right? So when you moved over to stage right, there were a few moments where you became where we couldn't really find you, couldn't see you. So just be aware of your stage location and because you're the star, right? I don't want to lose you. I don't want to lose you out of the light. So be sure everybody you find those spots and you stay in them so that we can really stay connected to you.
Yeah.
You know what the pros do when they sing really rhythmic songs that require a lot of them physically? You know how they get ready for big shows where they're moving around a lot?
They usually go to the gym, run a lot, sing while running usually too.
That's right. Get a treadmill, start singing your whole set on a treadmill, yeah. Right? That's literally what they do. So what I heard in this a couple of times was that you had moved, you had animated your movement to the point where your voice couldn't keep up. And you sounded a little out of breath in a few areas in the song. So just be careful that you balance what it is you want us to take away from this, because if you had to do that and then do another hour after it, you might be in trouble, right?
Exactly.
We all could probably pull something together for about 3 minutes, but we get ready to pull an hour of very rhythmic stuff that's kind of hype off, then we've got to really think through it. So I heard you getting a little winded, and that's okay, but just be mindful, right? Be careful, because the more winded we get, then our musicality starts suffering. So pitch is going to go a little crazy on us sometimes. You've also got a song that's really centered around the tonic. It's like centered around one pitch, like one or two or three pitches, which is very appropriate for the style. But it also means that you've got to, because you're coming in right on that pitch, you've got to be able to land it. Why does pitch matter? Why do we have to care about pitch? Should we even care about pitch, singers in the room? And why? Is it just because our music teachers told us to? Because if pitch is, where does pitch land? If something's out of tune, how does it make you feel? Why? Why does it make us feel, why does it, and this is no longer about you, Jolina, this is for all the singers. Why do we want to sing in tune in general? Speak up, I can't hear you. It's the right thing to do and it's pleasing, but nobody's given me a reason yet. Those are facts, but those aren't reasons, yes. No. Let's just think about what pitches really, what they do. You've got these waves, right? We're just talking about physics at this point, right? So if something's above or below pitch, we are literally uncomfortable in our body. That's what happens to the listener. People that don't know the first thing about music, when things are out of tune, they're uncomfortable. They couldn't tell you whether or not, the average person couldn't tell you whether or not you're sharp or flat, but they know something's off, right? That's because the physics of the experience of the way pitch lands in our body, it's because of the overtone series, right? So when you sing a quarter tone sharp, this is not Jelani, again, this is not for you. When you sing a quarter tone sharp or flat, you have literally messed with all of the way the body assimilates vibration, the way it assimilates the overtone series. And that's why triads are really pleasing to us. And the minute we add a major seventh, people go a little nuts, because that minor second creates a certain kind of dissonance. You go ahead and add a ninth above that or a sharp 11, and you're really pushing people's buttons, which is why jazz audiences are a little bit more curated, because they've created, the audience has accepted a certain kind of dissonance that they're willing to allow in their body during the performance. Do you ever consider that? That's why triadic music and popular music ends up being more ubiquitous and more popular, because it doesn't test us. So for the same reason those upper extensions and jazzy chords are sometimes threatening to an audience, the pitch around things can be the first thing outside of rhythm that we discussed earlier that can make your audience check out and get on Instagram, right? Because it literally is uncomfortable in the body. So I say that to you specifically when you're moving around. Just make sure you don't over-animate your song to the place where you can't control pitch, because you don't want to lose your audience. And the crazy thing is, sometimes we lose our listeners and they don't even know why. So it's up to us to start taking responsibility for this tour that we're taking our listeners on. And that's just one way we negotiate that. You're a ton of fun. I loved your track. Did you create the production on this?
I definitely was involved with all of the details and instructions about how I wanted it. I worked with the producer and orchestrated like the exact chords and everything that I wanted. It was pretty hands-on.
So you served up the ideas and the rest of it was a kind of a team effort.
Exactly. The producer is amazing, by the way.
That's a form of producing, right? Yeah. Producers sometimes don't necessarily move the knobs, but they know what they're looking for. So keep doing your thing. Thanks for sharing and putting yourself out there for us with an original song.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Right on.
Hi. hey. I'm Camilla Grattan. I'm from the LA area, and I'm 19. And I'm going to be singing My Future by Billie Eilish. And I just want to introduce the lovely people I'm up here with. This is Unique Zapata, and she's going to be on background vocals. Behind me, there's Charlie Tilton on drums. Then we have Jed Alper on bass. And Gonzalo Martin on keys and background vocals. Okay.
This is way too loud, sorry.
One sec. Oh, I'm not very funny.
I don't know what's happening.
Stop.
Technical issues, the piano's not working. Sorry.
Oh. Now.
Oh. What is happening? Is this not that?
We can work with that.
Not even the normal piano is working.
It's not turning back on. How's everyone doing? Yeah, that's great. Oh, whoa. There we go. I can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice I'm not here. I'm just a mirror. You check your complexion to find your reflections all alone. I had to go, but can you hear me? I'm not coming home. Do you understand? I've changed my plans, 'cause to know myself. I know supposedly I'm lonely now. No, I'm supposed to be unhappy without someone. But aren't I
Thank you.
Big Billy fan?
Yeah.
Yeah? Cool.
She's dope.
You sound lovely. First of all, I really appreciate the warm energy in this room. I can tell you guys really enjoy each other. The cohort vibe in here is really strong. I think it's a great place to learn, right?
Yeah.
Really, really enjoy it. Thanks for being so open and sharing so openly. Enter the most delicate beginnings of a song with the sure-footedness of the way you feel at bar 17. I'm going to say that one more time. Mm-hmm. I want you to sing bar 1 as assuredly as you would bar 17.
Okay.
So that means you have to be at bar 17 emotionally and mentally and physically as you start your song. I don't care how soft and delicate you're going to sing. I want you to already be in the experience prior to singing the first note. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And that energy that we can bring into bar 1 is really going to bring your audience vroom, right into the moment with you, okay? Mm-hmm. Your song had a question mark for the first 8 bars. Mm-hmm. Guess what? If you're my tour guide, I don't want you lost, mm-hmm. right? I want you to know in the map. And so that intimacy does not equal this lack of sure-footedness. You can be very intimate and still be very in control, okay? Mm-hmm. So keep that in mind. Separate those two things. Okay. Vulnerable and intimate still means that you're a very capable tour guide. So jump in there with the same kind of self-assuredness that you would already, because when you got to verse 2, you slayed me. Completely different experience of you by the time we got to verse 2 in this song. I'm like, oh, there she is. Wow, right? So, and I'm not talking about volume. I'm just talking about you showed up in the song in verse 2. Do you get where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
Okay. We talked about those vocal squeezes and compressions and whines and cries. You're really on your way. I think you could even go further. Let these ballads whine and cry in your tone. And that's what Billie's so great at. Yeah. She's really got that great compression, that kind of thing that makes those long tones and those soft tones feel so connected. I would love to see you employ your eyes when the band comes in.
Okay.
I want the air to lift up. I want it to spin a little faster. I want to be excited about being in a new section. And you gave me kind of a resident face that just didn't change. It said, no, I'm going to stay here. And I understand that Billie is the epitome of an understatement. I know that's her thing. But I still think there's an opportunity for you to make your statement here. Mm-hmm. What are you going to bring to the song? And I think there was it felt as though you had just decided that this is what the song does in this section as opposed to owning what it could be for you. Mm-hmm. So let those eyeballs get involved. The air will spin up. Things will get a little bit more interesting. You don't have to change the intimacy of what you're doing, but I think it'll invite the audience into those moments that the band comes in. We have to rise to meet the energy that's behind us, mm-hmm. right? And so always keep that in mind. They work for you. The band's there to support you, prop you up, bring you down, spread things thin, wide, whatever we're doing in the moment, but you have to rise to meet the moment. Mm-hmm. And there's an opportunity for you there just to maybe employ the face a little bit more in the second half of that tune. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Beyond that, keep in mind, everybody in the room, I could gush all night long about the wonderful things. I'm trying to jump to the little moments that might give you something to think about mm-hmm. that's more valuable. So just make sure that you understand that I've got tons of warm and fuzzies for you as well. But because we have such limited time, I'm going to jump to the small things that might allow you to think about how you can improve, okay? Mm-hmm. So that's why I'm going to end by saying it was extremely lovely. It was really, really musical, and I appreciate you sharing.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Hatja. I'm from Boston. I am 19 years old. I'm going to introduce the band. We have Tony on bass. And we have Zach on the drums. And then we have Maddie on the keys. Okay, the song I'm going to be singing today is All of Me, Ella Fitzgerald. You
Haja?
Yes.
Such a beautiful, such a beautiful job. Hey, bravo, band. Nice job up there, folks. So you have bitten off a very, very big, a very big thing here on this song. Medium swing, believe it or not, is one of the most difficult things to do. There's so much real estate between our phrases, and what we tend to do is, until we've done a deep, deep dive on the genre, it's really hard to know what to do, what to let go by, and what to fill up. Some of the people like Ella and Frank and some of those crooners that really, really know how to fill those bars up and when to leave them alone, even some of the newer folks like Bublé, who's a student of Frank, or Harry Connick, or you know, choose your jazz vocalist. They've done two things, and this is what I can guarantee you, that made them most effective, especially Ella. They've really paid a lot of attention to drummers. If you want to swing, you have got to create a mad relationship with drums in swing. Shadow goo jay goo gay goo bay goo gay goo. You got to really feel the way bass and drums pull through a groove. All of me, dun. Why not take all of me? Can't you see I'm no good without you? Take my lips, I want to lose them, girl, and take my arms. I'll never you. See what I'm doing? I'm playing with time. I'm in front of the beat, I'm behind the phrase, I'm over the bar, I'm within the bar. But that relationship to rhythm is what I want you to do a deep dive on. And then when you get ready to scat, who do you think we're gonna start concentrating on as a scatter?
Me?
No. Where are you going to get your inspiration from?
Oh, an artist?
No, I'm just saying, what kind of instruments should you be centered in on if you're going to become a great scatter?
Piano.
Sure, but what do you think might even be an easier target? Who do you think singers are mimicking most of the time when they get into their scatting?
Sax.
Horn players.
Horn players.
That's right.
Yes.
Horn players. How much transcription have you done? Literally, even orally, learning solos from horn players.
I've listened to a lot and had to choose from a lot of them on YouTube. Just solos, saxophone players play a lot.
Great. Have you transcribed a solo that you can sing note for note yet?
Not yet.
That's your homework.
Okay.
Okay. I want you to start learning Chet Baker solos. I want you to start learning Charlie Parker. You can start off with much simpler things, but I want you to start borrowing. There's a great book called Steal Like an Artist. Are you familiar with that book?
No.
It's a wonderful book. There's something I want you to start doing. I want you to literally start transcribing these horn lines, and that's going to give you the vocabulary you need for scatting. Okay? Because the great horn players outline the chord changes with their notes. Right on?
Right.
You're really, really ambitious in this. I'm so proud of you. Seemingly like it's no big deal, but a medium swing tune really is the deep end of the pool. And I give you a lot of credit for moving into this and taking interest in this music. Bravo to you. Keep doing what you're doing, okay?
Thank you.
Check 1, 2. Alrighty. Well, before I start, can we just give a hand to everybody that's been up before me, all these great singers tonight? First of all, y'all got me a little nervous to continue after you, but here we are. I'm Giovanni, I'm 23. I'm from LA. Fun fact, I don't know, you're going to be seeing my name on billboards one day, as I'm sure I'm going to be seeing y'all's on billboards. So, so the song I'm going to be singing tonight, Are You Happy Now? It's a bit of a breakup song. So, you know, I've found a new meaning for it, which I guess is good for the performance, but sucky for me. So, you're right. So, I hope you enjoy. Thank you. No, you're good. Take two.
Now, don't just walk away, pretending everything's okay, and you don't care about.
Sorry, typing back here. Great job, Giovanni.
Thank you.
Really fun to watch. You're a power, just a bundle of energy up there, man. Really, really great. I love how you I love how you embrace the moment and how you own your space. It was very effective. When you negotiate your passaggio up there in the very first time and you're going up into that head voice, make sure that when you lean into those notes, you don't pull up, you drop that jaw, and you really let those notes la. Go ahead and drop that jaw so that those sounds mix with something.
Okay.
They're more interesting.
Yeah, okay.
And make sure you leave the eyebrows out of the game. Singers, you know, you know when your eyebrows wince and we do that kind of thing and we do this kind of stuff? The throat gets tense, right? It all tightens up. It's all tied to the face. Everything we do is tied to the face. So when you go up to those things, just relax those eyebrows and lean in and trust that. It's going to mix with something. I don't want there to be that much disparity between the first time I hear those upper notes and the second time when you belt them, right? I'd love for there to be a little bit more continuity between those phrases because the first one felt like you kind of threw them away, okay?
Okay.
Great tenor tones. Dude, you've got a range. I'm jealous.
Thank you.
You've got those big natural A's up there and just lovely sound. Stay mindful of my mic proximity. Again, the same kind of comments I've been making all night. Two things. I started losing words because you were moving around a lot, and I want that mic glued to your face, right?
Okay.
And when you started moving around, I was losing kinda, you know, this kind of thing, and again, that takes me out of my moment. That takes me out of my body. And you don't want your listeners to come out of their body. You want them absolutely in the moment all the way through your song. You want to hold them captive, right?
Yeah.
So those are things that we can change that right off the bat, just take care of not losing them. I love your approach to the verses. Really, really cool. But the choruses need something more. You gave me most of what you had to offer in chorus one. So by the time I got to chorus three, I was wondering what was going to differentiate that experience for me. So sometimes we have to work backwards. If the biggest thing that we're going to do in chorus three shows up in chorus one, I'd like to hear a little less so that there's an arc, right? Because a song is a 3.5 minute commitment. And with people's attention spans today, we're lucky to get 15 seconds before they clue on down on Spotify,
really?
Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you've got to keep giving me reasons and dropping breadcrumbs to keep me interested.
Okay.
And if I hear the same level of intensity in chorus one that I hear in chorus three, I'm going to be wondering why I want to hang around.
Yeah.
So in the song arc conversation, just be mindful of those kinds of decisions. And you can say, hey, you know what? I'm going to pull that back by 15%. I'm going to mix that first chorus so that everybody feels like there's something that's going to continue to develop. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Great energy. I just want to commend you again. You were fun to watch.
Thank you.
And and I think I am going to see you on Billboard. So bravo. Great job.
You already know. Thank you. Well, thank you. And before I get off.
Thank you, Jim.
Came out of nowhere.
We need to be tight to that because we don't want to be here too late. But please come back in 3 minutes. We're just going to be right back. Thank you, Giovanni. And we'll come back with Rebecca. All right. Couldn't fake.
One, two. Hey, everyone. Today we're gonna swing in the rhythm of So, hello once again, I'm Rebecca. This is my second showcase today. And I have to thank these beautiful guys, David, Brandon, and Armando, for being with me the entire day. And we're gonna do something that you have to decide whether I'm twisted or not. He told me that I was right out of my head, the way he described it. He said I'd be better dead than alive. I didn't listen to his jive. I knew all along that he was all wrong, and I knew that he thought I was crazy, but I'm not. Oh no. My analyst told me that I was right out of my head. He said I knew doctrine, but I'm not that easily led. He said I was the type that was most inclined, went out of his sight to be out of my mind. And he thought I was nuts, no more ifs or ands or buts. They say as a child I appeared a little bit wild with all my crazy ideas, but I knew what was happening. I knew I was a genius. This was meant to be. Now I heard little children were supposed to sleep tight. That's why I've got into the vodka all night. My parents got frantic, didn't know what to do. But I saw some crazy things before I got to know. Do you think I was crazy? I may have been only three, but I was swinging. They left it in my young man. They left it in a song. Sorry if they just couldn't understand the idiomatic logic that went on in my head. I had a brain on the scene, oh, they used to laugh at me when I refused to ride on the double-decker buses because there was no driver on the top. You done, cowboy? My analyst told me that I was right out of my head, but I said, doctor, I think that it's you instead, because I have got a thing that's unique and new. To prove it, I'll have last laugh on you, because instead of one head, I got four. And you know, four heads are better than one.
Rebecca, is that right?
Rebecca, yes.
Wonderful job. And by the way, great shoes. Great shoes.
Thank you.
So tell me what kind of song that is.
It's a 12-bar blues, but I like it because it has more character. I really love musical theater, and I wanted to put these two things together.
Right on. But do you know what? Do you know the history of that song?
Not really.
So have you heard the phrase vocalese before?
No.
Vocalese is the idea of writing words to solos that existed beforehand. So these words were written by a lady named Annie Ross for a song from 1949 where a tenor saxophone player, Wardell Gray, played all the notes that in that melody that you just sang.
Oh, I heard any version. I just wasn't sure if that's the real history of the song.
Yeah. So what I want you to do is I want you to go find a recording. You probably find it on YouTube of the original saxophone solo. Yeah. And I want you to sing your song to the original sax solo.
Okay?
Because all the phrasing, again, that's another example of how singers go after horns. And then horn players are always ripping off vocalists because they love the lyricism and all the lyrical kinds of tendencies a singer has. We steal from each other in the most beautiful way possible. That's an iconic song in jazz, so go do a deep dive on that. You're really on your way, and bravo.
Thank you. Before we leave, I would love to invite my really dear friend, Unique.
Enjoy.
Hello. Hi. My name is Unique Zapata. I'm from Nebraska. And with me, I have my truly talented friend, Kamal, accompanying me today. Round of applause for him. Yes. And yes, I'll be singing Crazy. And I hope you enjoy.
Thank you, Unique. I love your name, by the way.
Thank you.
Really awesome. Very dramatic and beautiful. So that's not that far away from like the original tempo, but with the strong quarter note plotting kind of thing that's going on, it feels even more dramatic than it would if it had the kind of the 12-8 groove of the original. Have you heard the original?
very little. My grandma used to sing it to me when I was younger.
There is great value always in trying to go back and see what the origin story of a song is. And I'm not even beginning to insinuate that Jesse Reyes is not the, you know, just the cat's meow, right? But I want you to go back and listen to the way Patsy phrased, because I want you to have the largest conversation about this song that you can have. I'm always looking for numerous versions. If I pick a tune that I want to do, I want to hear seven people do it so that I can kind of be the confluence of all those different conversations and different variations of that song. And I would definitely recommend that you go back and give Grandma, you know, 15 minutes of homage there and give Patsy a quick listen on this, because I think it's gonna inform some of your decisions. But you have a beautiful voice. I would encourage you to remember that you're not only singing notes in a song, you're communicating ideas. And there were some really beautiful tones here, but there was a little lack of continuity in an overall kind of messaging standpoint. And if we were working together, I think you and I might be trying to really interrogate how you're going to get the point across, so that it was not just a wonderful collection of pitches, but you really told me a story, right? Mm-hmm. And that to connect with the lyric is something, it's one of the most difficult things that singers have to figure out how to do. You're well on your way, and I really enjoyed it. You have a lovely voice. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. And before I get off the stage, I'd love to announce my lovely friend Rocco. He is a Rocco rock star. So.
One, two, oh, haha. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I'd like to start by, I think I'll be speaking for all of us. I want to say thank you, Sean, for being here tonight. We really appreciate it. So just briefly about myself. My name is Rocco. I'm 21 years old. I am coming from Croatia, which is a little country in Europe that you probably don't know about. But anyways, I have quite a bit of experience that I gathered in my country, including representing my country at Eurovision Song Contest. And I think, yeah, let's leave it at a high note. Okay. Tonight I'm going to be singing All I Ask by Adele. Door. I won't say a word. They've all been said before, you know. So why don't we just play pretend like we're not scared of what is coming next?
are scared of having nothing left. Look, don't get me wrong, I know there is no tomorrow, and all I ask is if this is my last night with you, hold me like I'm more than just a friend, and give me a memory that I can use. Oh, take me by the hand while we do what lovers do. It matters how this ends. What if I never love again? I don't need your honesty. It's already in your eyes, and I'm sure my eyes, they speak for me. No one knows me like you do, and since you're the only one that matters, tell me, who do I run to? Look, don't get me wrong, I know there is no tomorrow, and all I ask is if this is my
guys.
What do you want me to say about that, Rocco? Come on, man. It was exceptional. Just exceptional.
Thank you
that
so much.
That was a master class in the cry and the whine that I've been talking about all night long. Did you guys hear that? That's that beautiful tearing, that crying that we just pull the voice through the song. It was exceptional.
Thank you so much.
Great emotional arc. Your piano playing really serves your voice really well. Extremely, just beautiful piano playing in the beginning of the tune.
Thank you.
You're a dynamic duo in a single package. It's amazing. Do me a favor. Concentrate on where you think the peak of this song is going to happen in the way that Adele does. Mm-hmm. What Adele doesn't do is give me three peaks in a song. She gives me one peak in a song. So that's the only comment I have, is that you've got to be so nuanced that when I finally get to what you feel is the most important part of the song, and I'm guessing you think it's at the key change at the very end of the tune, that you work backwards to make sure that everything else pays service to that moment. That doesn't mean we don't have big moments that lead up to that, but it just means that they can't go beyond where that peak of the song is. That is the master's level conversation that you're allowing me to have, because that was truly brilliant. So that's me splitting hairs because you've allowed me to. But that's the only comment I have. Beyond that, it was just exceptional, and you're a brilliant talent. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank all of you. Now, next up, we have a truly magnificent singer / songwriter, Jalen Friday, with his original tune. So give it up for Jalen.
Hi, my name is Jalen Friday. I'm 21 years old, and I'm originally from Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you. In 1986, my good sis Madonna made a song called Papa Don't Preach, testament for the times. And tonight, we're going to give you all our version of that. So Matthew, give me something hot. That was hot. Give us something.
Going to be upset, 'cause I was always your little girl. But you should know by now that I'm not a baby. You always taught me right from wrong. I need your help, Daddy, please be strong. I may be young at heart, but I know what I'm saying. Do without, well, we're in an awful mess, and I don't mean maybe. Please, Papa, don't preach. I'm in trouble deep. Papa, don't preach. I've been losing sleep, but I made up my mind. I'm keeping my baby. Ooh, you know I'm keeping my baby. Yeah, yeah. He says that he's gone. Raise a little family. Maybe we'll be alright. It's a sacrifice. Ooh, but my friends keep telling me to give it up, saying I'm too young, I ought to live it up. What I need right now is some good advice. Please, Papa, don't preach. I'm in trouble deep. Papa, don't preach. I've been losing sleep, but I made up my mind. I'm keeping my baby. Ooh, you know I'm keeping my baby. Yeah, yeah. Come on. Daddy, daddy, if you could only see
just how good he's been treating me. You give us your blessing right now, 'cause we are in love. Yes, we are in love. Oh, Papa, don't preach. Come on. I've been troubled deep. Papa, don't preach.
What?
I've been losing sleep. Papa, don't preach. Huh. I'm in trouble deep. Papa, don't preach. I've been losing sleep. But I made up my mind. I'm keeping my baby. Ooh, you know I'm keeping my baby. Yeah, yeah.
Papa, don't preach.
Oh, no.
I'm in trouble deep. Papa, don't preach.
Keeping my baby. Oh, Papa, don't preach.
To watch, Jalen.
Thanks.
You had great focused energy in the verses. You really brought me in. You really pulled me into the moment with you. Extremely focused. You're a great storyteller. I love this arrangement. Really cool arrangement with cajon and all of that. Great job, background singers and band. Really good. When you open up into the upper parts of your resonance, your pharyngeal resonator comes in. The real cool. You know, the stuff that shows up in great gospel music and great rock stuff, all your pharyngeal resonance opens up. I want you to know that you can employ that resonance in the lower parts of these verses. There's a little bit a lack of a point, and the stuff sounds just a little bit, I don't know, soft's not the right word, but it just doesn't have a, I'd love for there to be a little bit more point to the sound when you're in the lower part of your range, and all you've got to think about is getting to that squeaky door part of your pharynx, all right? It's that wonderful stuff back there that just adds that brassy, that point to it. That'd be the only comment I would suggest is that we won't lose you in your verses. But man, when you open up, it's really something special and just a blast to watch. You sound great. Thank you.
Thank great you job. So much. How could I forget? Coming up next, we got my good sis, Eliza. She's about to eat the house down Mama Boots Coral.
Maybe a little bit less because it's doing this. Do, do, do. 1, 2, 3. Is it okay? Hello, my name is Eliza. And so
I don't know how I will perform after two grands, but thank you, David, about the list. So, I want to thank you, the guys who will be accompanying me. So, Gonzalo on the piano, Benton on the drums, and Lucas on the bass. Let's calm down.
The future without you. The hell was I doing in the past? Now that I learn all about you, the love just like ours would last. I won't fall for your games, so don't hate me when I say that you don't do it for me anymore, that you don't do it for me anymore. Money won't pay your problems, you gotta fix them for yourself. Now that I've learned all about you, stop feeling bad for yourself. I won't fall for your games, so
that is such a hard song, and you killed it.
Thank you.
Really, really good. You have such a beautiful, gentle tone in the beginning of the song, and you did an amazing job navigating a song with such incredible range. It's really, there's a lot there. I really, really want to commend you on opening up into those head tones in a very effective way, too. I could feel the jaw coming down. I could feel... they didn't get small. They stayed big. They mixed really well. Really great job there. Make sure the bridge means the most on this tune. Why do we have bridges, by the way? Anybody know? Why do pop songs always end up with a bridge?
It's the part that develops to the...
I didn't hear you. Yeah, well, it's all in the most simplest terms. We stick a bridge in somewhere around the last two thirds of the song so that we'll still care about the chorus when it comes back around, right? It's like a palate cleanser, right? That's why these iconic song forms have lasted since 1950. It's because the bridge, if the song's been huge, the bridge may break down. If the song's been kind of mellow, the bridge may be something huge. It offers contrast, and it offers a real moment for us to take somebody on a journey so that when we get back to that chorus, we're so happy to be there, okay? This bridge is a big opportunity. It's a gift wrapped like a present for you. And you, it's in a sweet spot in your voice, but it's not the highest part of the song. But I want you to go search for what's going to make this bridge even more special for you. Last thought, don't let your breakdown chorus come quite so far back down. I think at that point you could bring the floor up of that breakdown chorus up 15-20%. It would still, by contrast, seem plenty soft. But it disappeared on me, and all of a sudden I found myself checking out of the tune, and I don't want to do that. So when you come out of that bridge, make sure you don't go quite so low. When you finally start belting at the end of this tune, it's such a joy to listen to. Keep singing this song. It needs to stay in your repertoire. You're killing it. Really Thank wonderful you. Job. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next one will be Makessa, right? Check one, two. Oh, hello, everyone. How are we doing tonight? How amazing is it that we can finally do live music together? It's amazing. I haven't been on the stage. I'm in my quarter eight right now, so I haven't been on the stage since my quarter one. Crazy. So this is a little nerve-wracking. Besides Jalen and I, everyone here is like freshmen to sophomore, so props to you guys for coming up here and really giving your all and like doing your thing. So yeah, congrats. While they're setting up, my name is Makessa. My parents raised me for failure because my name is Makessa and people butcher it all the time. So I will not be going by Makessa. I will be going by Mally Edge with my band. In the band tonight, we have Judah on lead guitar. We have Charlie on drums and we have Sam on bass who just learned the song yesterday. I will talk about my song real quick. I'm doing an original song called The Numbers Game that will be dropping on January 1st. So look out for that on all streaming platforms. Yeah, so this song is about a toxic relationship and you're just kind of at the point where you just, like, they keep calling you and they want to get back together with you and you're just like, F you, like, I'm tired of your bullshit. Yeah. Like I said, you're tired of their emotion. And so, you know, you just want to tell them. We're going to do that again. Okay. Yeah, see, we're testing you guys. Okay. One, two, three, Texas. One, two, three, Texas said. Who would've known that we'd be here, sitting in the river of all your
tables. 1, 2, 3, text you said. 4, 5, 6, get the hay. And 7 months went by. Another 8 that I cried. But there won't be a night this time. I mean, another reason to say goodbye.
Pay to see that. I'm pretty sure I would.
Thank really, you. Really Sorry great. For the rough intro, guys.
No, it's all good. You know what I love? In rooms like this, and even in large stages, if you share your inconvenient truths, it makes you the most powerful person in the room. Keep that in mind. So you did something that really, really endeared you to your audience. You got out in front of the things that were, you know, keeping you inside your head. And that literally releases all the tension in those moments. And I want to applaud you on that. It's very endearing. And you did it in a very honest way. So great for that. I was ready for you to win before you sang your first note because of all of that, that share. So I love the punk energy in this tune. I love the guitar tones. Great job, guitar man. Great performance. And big comma, and you guys have got to make sure that the relationship between the lead vocal when you're singing is still more important than the guitar. And then, so that means the guitar's got to carry that kind of energy, but it can't overtake the lead vocal. And that's a hard thing to do in a punk song when you want the tones to be crazy, because we know you got to be loud. It's got to break up just to get into the right vibe for the song. So that's the work in this tune, is just to make sure that you don't get, you know, overtaken by some of the really cool things that are going on in the band. Believe it or not, a lot of the most effective mixing happens on stage. It's not something that can be done out in front of the house. It's decisions that you guys make as an ensemble about how you're going to find that balance. You have an incredibly lovely big sound, very powerful, absolutely just hit me. It's happening. This is a big song to sing cold. You had to sit here for an hour and a half waiting to sing this song. It's the least ideal thing you could do. When you're finally out there headlining your own shows at the the big stadiums and arenas, you're going to want to warm up beyond the needs of your songs. And that means you're going to want to take your time. You're going to want to warm up a little bit for 15, 20 minutes and then take a little time off and then come back to that and really, really phonate. Get big, big, big tones so that you've warmed up beyond the needs of these big, powerful songs and you don't do any damage. And most importantly, after this kind of night is over, you're going to want to warm down. Are you familiar with warm down exercises? Excellent.
Yes.
Singers, if you don't know what I mean, ask around. It's a big deal. You want to make sure that the tears that occurred while you're doing these big songs and belts are repaired before you put that voice to bed at the end of a long night like that. Excellent job. Can't wait to see you on the big stage.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you, guys. So closing our show tonight is Morgan. Y'all are ready to get your socks knocked off. Let's go.
Thank you.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? My name is Morgan, and these are the boys. This is Hunter on electric guitar. We've got Charlie on drums. The one and only Henry Thrill on the bass. And Connor is playing keys. And much love to Connor because he literally learned this song overnight and he's been such a trooper and appreciate it so much. My name is Morgan. I go by Mo Bentley. And a little bit about me. I've been singing for a while. Yeah, I love music. I'm really taking a turn with my music and trying to do something different and be more of myself. And yeah, just being me, doing Mo Bentley. I know you guys have been sitting, so why don't we get up and let's dance. Let's have some fun. Let's go. Come on, let's get up. Let's get up. The song that we're performing is an original that we've been working on for a very, very long time. There's a lot of writing credits on it. Literally, all my best friends in that section all wrote on it. It's amazing, so let's hit it. Yeah.
Thank you.
dropped my mic. Oh my God, that's so embarrassing.
Yo, yo, check, 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 check. Can you hear me?
Wow.
Are you guys a band all the time, with the exception of the keyboard player, learning at the lunch?
Yeah, technically, yeah.
Because it sounds rehearsed, and it sounds really cool. The orchestration and production decisions are really, really lending a lot of value to this song. Kudos, band. Great job. Great musical decisions about the way, like the opening Mellotron flutes and all that stuff, just really super cool, vibey, dramatic. And the ups and downs, the ebbs and flows that the band carved out for you vocally are really effective in this song. So mm-hmm. It sounds like you've worked it out a lot.
Yeah.
And it really does go a long way to supporting your voice. Really dramatic and cool. I love the sound of your voice. You've got a great vibe. And it's extremely, extremely marketable in pop rock. You're on it. What else was I going to say here? I really appreciate the fact that you opened up at the end. You saved something for me. Here's the only thing I'm going to offer you. And while we want to be grunge and punk and move around and dance around, I want you to face your audience and stay in star mode.
Okay.
Because this kind of song needs to grab me around the throat and not let go of me.
I agree.
In a proverbial kind of way, right? And so when you give way or you defer and you lean back and you look back, that's cool maybe once or twice, but I want you to stay so viscerally connected to your audience in a song like this that I just can't take my eyes off of you. Mm-hmm. And if you look away from me, you invite me to look away from you.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So keep that in mind. Stay in star mode the whole time because you can pull it off. You've got the vibe, you got the persona, and you've got the voice to pull it off.
Thank you. So
well
much.
Done. Great job,
Thank
guys.
You.
All right. That was awesome, you guys. That was awesome, you guys. Please give it up for all the wonderful performers tonight. Woo! So different, so musical, so real, so you. That's awesome. I want to give a special, special thanks to Sean Holt for coming out here tonight. For all his great comments, really smart. To be honest, I was the first half. It was just everything that he said. I was like, that was great. That was great. That was great. And I said on the second half, I said, so those of you on the second half got a little bit less comments, but it was only because of my decision that I just said, Sean, I don't want you to stop saying anything that you're saying, but I want to make sure that we get out of here by 10:15. I think that's what we're doing. So. Again, one more big round of applause for Sean Holt. Thank you so much.
Bravo to all of you guys. It was an inspiring night out. Thank you so much for letting me share with you. I enjoyed you very much. Congrats. Have a great holiday.
He's written up some comments. Those of you who performed, if you'd come up to the front, we'd love to get a picture with all of you and with Sean, if you would, if you'd be willing. Thanks.